Good morning. Want to speak to you this morning about the importance of being consistent and setting deadlines, because a lot of us are actually doing things in our business with an ad hoc approach. And I use this term ad hoc. I studied Latin at secondary school level, but I'm sure many people know what the word ad hoc means. But for me, you know, it's very important that I get something clear with you. None of the work that I did was in vain. None of the work that I did and I still do now was without a reason, a rationale. So I often talk about the bigger picture. I often talk about setting goals. I often talk about being really clear on your targets. And one of the things that I know I'm able to do really well is, good morning, Diamond. Good morning, Leanie. How are you doing? Good morning to you, tax assist over there embarking. I'm able to deliver results really well because I have a focus, and I always encourage my clients, you know, to have a focus. Morning, Pastor Henry, how you doing? I always encourage as well my clients to have a focus. I always encourage people to try and stay on track, have an agenda. You know, if you're going to meetings, be really clear on why you're going to those meetings. If you're traveling to appointments, be really clear on why. You know, what do you want to get at the end of the meeting? What do you want to get at the end of the, you know, appointment you're attending? And just be really clear on your goals. But when it comes to consistency, this is something I think there's a bit of a grey area, because a lot of us will think consistency basically means writing a to-do list and trying to do stuff. But what consistency means is good habits. It means routines. It actually means you saying, okay, today, Wednesday, I've got 3 key tasks to do, and I need to do them. And that might look like the following Wednesday, you're also saying and doing the same thing. Consistency is about good habits, best practices, and you actually doing things typically at the same point or same time. Now, it could be a habit such as drinking water every morning. It could be a habit when it comes to walking to work every day. But you know that if your end goal from drinking water is to have clearer skin, or if you're walking to work to lose weight, as examples, then you know that if you don't drink the water daily, and if you don't, you know, walk to work every day, your results will not be the results you're looking for, right? So first of all, when we're talking about consistency, yes, you need goals. The second thing you need is a plan on how you're going to achieve those goals. So if you know that you want to lose weight, if you know that you want to drink more water, but for example, you don't have water running in your house, as an example, really weird example, but just as an example, then it would be unrealistic for you to say you're going to drink water every day unless you know you can get to a water fountain or a river or wherever it is you live or however it is you operate to ensure you can drink that water every day. So you've got to be clear on what you can do to achieve those goals. And it's exactly the same thing in business. If you know that you want to achieve sales, if you know that you want to get leads, if you know that you want to actually get people knocking on your door or coming into your shop or visitors coming to your website, if you know that you actually want to have customers, yeah, then there are lots of things you've got to do consistently, probably every day, or certainly at least once, you know, or twice every other day to make sure you get the results. So if you're expecting to get lots of customers in and you have a service-based business and you do an online, you know, service, you can't really expect people to flock to your business unless you're visible frequently, and also unless you are actively making offers and also reaching out to people and engaging with them. It's not just about the likes. It isn't just about the likes. It's not just about you saying, okay, because I've got this online business that I know people need, you know, the clients will come to me. It's not about that. You've got to be clear on, you know, how you're going to attract those customers. And then your plan has got to be one which you can realistically achieve that can keep you consistent, right? So if you've got this big ambition to make £20,000 in a week or £20,000 in a month, for example, you need to make sure that you're taking consistent action to achieve that. And, you know, along with consistency, you might have things like automation and certain processes in your business. So in my business, I've got various processes that I use, and I'll be sharing lots of my resources and tips at my masterclass coming up on the 6th and 7th of July. I've got certain processes and you know, things that I use in my business to ensure that I've got structure, that if people contact me, they can easily book an appointment, they can easily converse with me, we can have professional calls. I don't need to physically be out of my home office or out of the office because there's a certain way I can conduct meetings, which is all about time efficiency and all about the best ways of working, in my opinion. And I do want to say as well as a word of caution, every single expert, guru, professional will have some form of bias when it comes to the advice they give. And I want us all to recognize that. So what I'm sharing with you today are tips that I know will work. Hey, how you doing? And I'm sure every other guru or expert will tell you tips that they believe will work. I've had experience in doing this now for over 23 plus years, but in the last 6 plus years, I've had experience of actually doing it in my own business. And what I know will not work is inconsistency. So deciding you'll turn up on a Monday and start doing lots of posts on social media, and then you'll not return back to social media until Thursday, not necessarily going to give you the results you want. As I said earlier, if you've just watched the live now, you can catch the replay and you'll see that I was saying, if you need, you know, to get certain results, then you will do certain things. If you feel that you want to lose weight, you want to, you know, grow your hair, you might need to do treatments, you might need to do certain recipes. You have to be consistent to get those results. And it's exactly the same thing in business. Just let me know with the number one in the comments box if what I'm saying makes sense. If you take consistent action, you will see the results, okay? If you are clear on the why, the goals, what you're doing and why you're doing it, if you're really clear on the structure you're going to have in your business to help you achieve those goals, right? What you're actually going to do to ensure that you can deliver on those goals with a realistic time frame, not being ambitious. Morning, Carol. Not being over ambitious and thinking that you can do it all. Actually managing your own expectations. Because the thing is, a lot of us talk about consistency and then we go too hard. And unfortunately, when we go too hard, we might not get the right outcomes because perhaps we haven't got the clarity on the right tactics and methods we should be using to get the results, right? Or we'll go too hard and we are using the right results and unfortunately it burns us out. So we might start making money, but we just feel really tired and exhausted at the end of it. Who wants to be in a business in either of those cases? You know, if you haven't got clarity and you're consistently doing the wrong things because you're not clear on how to get your target audience to buy from you, how to price your products, how to actually coordinate your marketing activity, how to organize your budget, how to manage your time, then a consistent approach isn't really going to be of any benefit to you because you're consistently doing things that aren't getting you results. So I'm just going to quickly recap. If you're watching this now, you may or may not be aware, I started my business on less than £100, and what I do now is actually coach and consult for brands such as Virgin Business Startup, NatWest Bank, and also the Sherry Blair Foundation. I have international clients that I also mentor. And, you know, it's important to me that I get this message out, even at a local level. You know, I've got my clients in the Caribbean and the US and parts of Europe, but actually here in the UK, the word needs to get out. If you think that by being inconsistent, you can somehow magically grow your business. You know, I'm not trying to throw shade on anyone or be negative, but it's time that you had a wake up call because we're now in June. You've got till December before we hit 2020. And, you know, if you're not currently taking consistent action, and by that I mean if you haven't got a routine, and routines normally work well when you've got some kind of plan, right? Which is like a swear word for some of you, I'm sure. Then unfortunately you won't get the results you deserve, the results you want, the results you may not even know you're capable of achieving. So for those of you that are watching now, I would love for you to just put the word plan, P-L-A-N, plan, into the comments box, plan. To let me just know and understand that you are with me, that you comprehend what I'm saying here. Because the thing is, for consistency to work, you've got to have a routine. For you to have a routine, you've got to have a plan. That's why when you go to people like, for example, Cambridge Diet or, you know, your local gym, fitness plans, things like that, they will give you a plan, won't they? They'll give you a plan of some kind that you need to follow with daily tasks, maybe a diet or recipes and things like that, because it's about good habits and it's about consistency. So something for you to think about today. If you know that you don't have a plan, if you know that you perhaps might need some support with planning, maybe you need clarity on how to spend your budget, or you just want advice on how to attract real results, more website hits, more customers, paying clients, yeah? Then all you've got to do is message me, comment on the live, let me know you've watched the replay if necessary, if you catch the replay, and let me know you need my help. Because the thing is, the year's slipping on, it's slipping away. And I think a lot of us are complacent, thinking things are going to change without us taking any action. But the thing is, things only changed in my business when I started to get out of my comfort zone. And I know it will be the same for you. If you're watching this now and you're in a place of comfort, it might be time that you considered getting uncomfortable. And now could be a really good time for you to consider being uncomfortable. Because at the end of the day, how you show up, where you show up, your consistency, and also your habits and best practices is what's going to get you the best results. There's no kidding. You can sign up to all the free webinars you want, all the workshops you want, even paid masterclasses if you want. But if you don't apply consistency in your business, you'll probably find it really difficult to get the results that you deserve. So have a think about that. Consistency and setting deadlines. Get your plans together. If you need the help, there's a link in the bio. You can also message me direct. Please do go over to the IGTV channel. There are lots of videos there with tips. And let me know how you get on. All right, take care. Bye.